What does a legacy look like? Is it a number? Is it a word? Is it something to be documented, described, or measured? When future generations look back, what will the imprint of our legacy be? Our legacy is found in tradition, in community, in the search for knowledge, the value of service, and the continuity of our Masorah. It's a legacy not stumbled upon, but painstakingly constructed from years of determination, days of dedication, hours and hours of sacrifice, and countless moments of vision. What does our legacy look like? Is it one student? Is it one school? One shul? One community? Simply put, yes. Our legacy has many sizes, shapes, aspirations, and intentions. We are our legacy. We are our future. We are HTC.
If you walk throughout the city of Chicago, or practically any city with a Jewish community, you will immediately see the impact that Hebrew Theological College has.
We're able to reach a great range of students, and we've done that for almost 100 years. There's many students out there who are shining in the Jewish world and the general world as great leaders, great scholars, and this is all part of our history, our legacy.
So many of our Talmidim have gone out, taken important positions within the community based upon the education they've received here in the yeshiva, both within our high school and our base medrash.
HTC is vitally important to the community. And at least I know from my perspective, a lot of the people who I'm involved with in terms of organizational work and community work, their roots came from the yeshiva.
They produce fine young men and women who are going to be leaders in the Jewish community. They're not only academically prepared in a secular sense, but they're fully grounded in Torah and Yiddishkeit, as exemplified by Rabbi Eisenberg, who's never stopped studying. He's never stopped growing.
Rabbi Dr. Gerald Eisenberg certainly has been the leader of this institution for so many years, so many decades, and he has been so instrumental in the tremendous success which we've enjoyed for so many years.
First time I started as a student was in June of 1967. I attended a summer program, and I remember looking at some of the buildings and seeing how gigantic they were, just humongous, and feeling so small.
He's been connected to Yeshiva basically all his life. Of course, he was a student, and he received the smicha here as dean of students, as the principal of the high school, chancellor. And he's given his life and soul to this institution. So therefore, what happens here and what will happen here has to do with his very being, his very essence.
From the students to the faculty to the staff, everything the yeshiva is going to be in the future is because he was involved heavily in every decision that was made.
He went from the principal, vice principal, to principal of the high school, to vice president, to chancellor, you know, and he really took the yeshiva with him to great heights. I remember accreditation. He wanted a proper North Central accreditation, and so therefore students who would go from here would have the chance for a positive degree.
He brings that wealth of perspective with him and has given the institution a different understanding of itself with that understanding of a bigger picture.
He was always about quality on the inside and working with the community on the outside. He provided great leadership, and above all who know Jerry know that he is just such a mensch.
He has been a Rebbe in Chochmas HaChaim, in the wisdom of living. And most importantly, he has taught me what it takes to build Torah living and Torah learning in the many supportive roles that are so fundamental to enable Torah to thrive and to flourish.
His amazing experiences here at the Hebrew Theological College have had a tremendous impact on me and my knowledge and ability to become a better administrator. Seeing the time and the effort he puts into his job is certainly an inspiration for all of us to work even harder and to do our best as we follow in his ways and in the efforts that he's shown over the many, many years that he's been working here at Hebrew Theological College.
Everything that my father was able to accomplish at the yeshiva, he accomplished because of two things. One, of course, was our mom, who was his rock and his voice of reason and his counsel. And the second is because he always went with his gut, which is significantly smaller now, but still as effective. That led to the success that he was able to take the yeshiva to.
An individual has to make his own mind up of how he wants to live in this world and serve the Rabbono Shel Olam. When we see that the Torah being learned here, the lessons being studied here, are then carried forward by our alumni to their communities, and you realize that you had a part in that young man's development, they are making a positive contribution, and we, in this institution, have had an opportunity to help make that possible. Yeshiva is more than the campus, more than the buildings, and more than the walls. Yeshiva has a soul. You can see the soul in the eyes of the Rebbeim. You can hear the soul in the sounds of Torah being learned by the students. You can feel it in the atmosphere that's generated when Torah is being learned. That's really what drives this institution.
Skokie is more than just a school. It's more than just an experience. It's a life-changing type of yeshiva.
It's all encompassing in setting down the foundations of how these boys will become the next generation of our leaders and bring us into the next century.
The sense of community, the sense of learning, the sense of commitment to Yiddishkeit that HTC imparts in each of its students is the life I live. I am HTC.
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 Ani HTC.
I am 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 HTC.
We are HTC.